Well, you've been patiently waiting for it, and now I'm getting to the 72 Chevrolet Pickup Racer's Wedge Edition, 1/25th scale, sent over by Round 2 Models under the MPC brand. You can build this truck two different ways. You can build it as the awesome Racer's Wedge truck, or you can build it as a stock truck with the 350 underneath the hood. So let's take a look at all the stuff that'll be in the box, because you know you're going to order yours. First, we'll get out the huge pieces of styrene to make the wedge on the back. You can see all kinds of accessories included in this kit, like toolboxes, floor jacks, pump jacks, all different kinds of things. But we got the nice detail there that does have the expanded metal texture to it. We've got the wedge body, huge slug of styrene. Any more styrene, they'd make you join OPEC. We got all different parts of the box on there. Careful, some of these little loop parts are on the tree, really loose. We got doors. Looks like they may even open. We'll have to find out about that. If you choose to have an operating kit, we've got our interior tub. We've got our cab. The interior tub has the bucket seats molded in with the console and the door panels. These trucks aren't very fancy inside, so it's not a concern. All one thing, easy to paint and detail. We got our fenders in there. We got our radiator molded in, battery molded in, firewall detail. Nice molding, thick, prominent molding on there. Easy to detail and highlight. Got some side moldings on there. Little fuel tank, door handles, cab back. Nice looking Chevy body. It's a lot of styrene in here. That's why the box is extra big. On this simple tree, we just got a radiator line and some wheel backs. We've got the chassis here. You can see the entire driveline and exhaust system built in. And front suspension. Very easy to work on underneath. We got the stock bottom of the bed here. We got a radiator. We've got air cleaners. Various small parts. Looks like a heater and blower motor. I always like knowing what's in these because the customizers want to pick these up. We got another radiator line. We got tailgate components. And that nice hood. Underhood detail molded in. So depending on which way you're going to build it, you're still going to have a lot of extra parts. We have a beautiful tonneau cover that should work on almost any other pickup truck. It's even creased at the corners with a nice vinyl texture to it. Open on the back, closed on the front, or vice versa. We got our stock dashboard, identical to the one in the 72 GMC Jimmy I just did. More wheel backs. Parts for that 350, water pump, carburation, belt and pulley system, all separate on this one. Exhaust and downpipes are one piece. Stock steering wheel. And we've got the last parts of white styrene, and then we got to go to the other side of the table. We've got the sides of the standard long bed. That molding trim follows all the way through from the cab, so it doesn't mismatch. We got more body moldings here, you can see. We've got our steelies. There should be six here, one fell off. I have it on the side. This is your rear axle for when you do the racer's wedge with the twin axles in the back. This is how it attaches. It's very, very simplistic, but it does the part of getting you your extra axle and wheels underneath the body. We'll switch to the other side of the desk, whip out El Chrome pieces. Check out all these accessories here. We've got lights, floor jack, beautiful set of mirrors. We got a vise, fire extinguisher. I've built a lot of these in other reviews. We got a saw, hammer, screwdriver, wrenches. I mean, just all kinds. We got a four-way wrench there. All kinds of cool stuff on that chrome tree for accessories. Another carburetor for a spare part. Love these parts packs. Custom steering wheel, custom valve covers, stock grille with headlights molded in, bumpers, custom grille on this one, cross lace custom wheels, stock mirrors. Chevy emblem we can put on separately so we can paint it up a gold and get it on the grill. Excellent chrome in there. We got a one-piece glass, lights, and tail lights. We've got six total tires, three steel axles. These are Goodyear polyglass, white wall on one side, black wall on the other. Depending on how fancy you want to make your pickup truck, you'll get six of those total. So you do, you know, have the racer's wedge tires, or you'll have two extra. And a gorgeous new decal sheet. Beautiful striping for that racer's wedge and over the hood. Get up close, let you see all the cool little stuff on there. Chevy emblem, sponsor decals. First we'll tow it, then we'll race it. All kinds of awesome sauce. In the white here for Wary Racing, it says we're Wary Fast. Wary is the last name of a guy who builds a lot of the beautiful box art kits for round two models. He builds those up for him, does an excellent job. He did the Supernatural for him. He does a lot of great work, and it's kind of cool that they would go ahead and name some decals after him and put it on the sheet there. That's everything that's in the box when you get your 72 Chevy Racer's Wedge. I'm going to start assembling my version and be right back. Assembly on this kit took a lot less time than I thought, only about 2 hours at the most, and I've got it all ready to go. It is actually quite simple. I thought that Racer's Wedge body on the back was going to be quite an extensive build, and it wasn't. It really just goes together so well, which shows that even though it's an older mold, it is made pretty well. The 350 is all assembled. If you've watched the show before, you know how much I love hand painting stuff on models. It takes me back, and that's why I do this, for the nostalgia, for the memories, and for the fun. Makes a nice 350. Glued all the parts on so you can see it. Got the stock valve covers. I'm going to do this as a regular stock work truck. Got the manifolds on. Everything's glued together with model glue. I'll go in and paint the carburetor, the coil, the distributor, the exhaust, and the downpipes all separately, as well as the starter and the oil filter when I get to that point. And the transmission, of course. We know what I love to use on the transmission. So very easy to put together. Goes together nice. If you feel like removing these seams and stuff, go ahead and sand them off. But I build quick and fun, and don't worry. The belt pulley, we got an air pump, we got an alternator. All goes together quite easily. Nice assembly. We'll get some paint on that, and then I'll just do the alternator in a metallic color. And we know that that is assembled well and will fit under the hood. Don't forget your radiator line. That'll need to go on when we're all done. Got the wheel backs and the wheels all ready to be painted up. I haven't decided what color I want to do those in. I test fit the rear axle on. That's why you've got some wheel backs on some of the axles, just to make sure everything lined up the way it should. We got our loose wheel. Our front wheels go on with these larger studs, so you can glue these parts in the back, or you can just pressure fit them if you want your wheels to roll. But I don't want my stuff rolling off the table, so I glued it in permanently so that when this is all done, this heavier kit doesn't go anywhere. The hood's all ready to be painted. You can paint that body color, you can paint that a contrasting color, whatever you choose to do. It's your model. We got the ramps, the wheel chocks for the back here, and there are three positions. We got the stops here. Those can go where the ramps went in the back slots that you'll see in a moment to stop the vehicle from coming off completely. And then we got our ramps individually, which of course we can slide up further on the body, throw in the center, use whatever we want. Those are all set to go as they are on the tree. These components here will be attached separately: our heater, air cleaner, washer tank, and brake master cylinder. Those all can be painted up and then hand detailed and glued under the hood when we're done. And the dashboard. You can decide how you want to go with the dashboard, body color, or go a custom truck and paint it custom, whatever you like. I'm going to do mine similar to how I did it on the GMC Jimmy review. So that's on its own tree and set to go. Now I have taped together the body so you can see how it's going to sit. It makes for a beautiful size model. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and a half inches long from front to back. If you're ever wondering how big anything is on the show, these grids are 1 square inch. So if I don't count it out, you can do it yourself. You can see how nice that's going to look all put together. The cab drops down beautifully. It's got these two pins here to locate it. You're not going to have any problems making sure it's in the exact perfect spot and push down. The interior goes in super nice. Push the back down. It's got these two nice clips. Those go into the two holes under the cab. You can do that a million times. Sometimes these pickups go together rough, but this just goes in and push up as far as it'll go, and it snaps into place, and you're all done putting your interior in. How lovely is that? So we're going to be painting the interior. We got the cab, which doesn't require any glue or anything at this point. We got the chassis all set to go on that Racer's Edge body. I've got it taped into place. I'll now remove the tape. You can see, don't cut these tabs off if you're doing the Racer's Wedge, but you will have to follow the scored lines on the chassis that we saw and just slice it off. I just used my nippers and then sanded them a little more flush. Those will need to come off so that you can get your rear axle in. Your rear axle glues in tightly, lines up with that last. There's a frame bar here, a cross member. There's one here. It lines up with it, center it. It sinks around those frame rails. Glue it in place, glue the drive shaft in, and you're all set. And then you can see your indentations on the Racer's Wedge on the back. This piece just friction fits in, if you assemble it correctly, into its little groove. It's just, I mean, it's a nice tight fit and it holds everything securely. The doors on the side will open up if you wish them to on the hinges. I glued everything in place. I have no intentions on opening those up. And if I did, I'd break them off before this build was over. So I glued them shut, but they will open and they do have interiors. So you can place items in there. That Wedge body looks awesome. We got positions to install cars on here. We got storage for the ramps and tools and equipment in the center. And you can see all that all goes together lovely and looks awesome. The reason these grooves are here, when you place your body on, you'll know if you have everything lined up correctly, because those will center in place there as a marker. And there's notches on the chassis that will line up with your front part of the Wedge body, and that all goes together like so. And that's it. That's as easy as this is. It looks great and it's super easy to assemble. I'm gonna get some color on mine and I'm not gonna go conventional. I want it to stand out. We'll be right back.
Thank you. Thank you.
There's a quick test fit of the back of the Wedge and the cab on there. I did my scratching on the racer's Wedge there. That's just going to come off, and you can see the detail. I even glued in the color match toolbox for now. The only other thing I'm going to be putting in there that I think will look neat will be the jack that I left chrome, like a chrome steel, and then black washed all over it, so it looks like it's been used at least one time. And the rest of the stuff I'm just going to leave out. In my other reviews, you've seen me build these nice little tool sets and use the tools and stuff like that. On this tree, what I still want to use are the big mirrors on the side and the taillights that will go on the back of the Wedge once it's all assembled, sitting on tires and sitting high off the ground. So I've got those red lights on there. You can also use these lights here with the red inserts, but I like the look of these on the bottom. And those mirrors are really beautiful. Single piece, don't have to fight with them. We'll be able to get those glued onto the side of the cab. The inside of the cab will look like so. We got that nice interior with the metal dash matching the body like in the Jimmy. We got the leather brown interior, just the plain Jane work truck interior, and the blacked out dash top with the Chevy steering wheel, and I used a little bit of a gold marker to highlight that bow tie in the center of the steering wheel. Otherwise, you saw me detail the dashboard and get that all to show, and it looks lovely. The grill itself is done. That just goes right in. There is a little hole you can open up to attach the bow tie, so you make sure you get it centered perfectly. That will lock into the cab with those large tabs. You shouldn't have any problems putting that on. We've got the ramps and the wheel chocks and the stops there. We got our air cleaner to go. We got our radiator hose to go once the cab is on. We've got our little miniature cab clearance lights that you saw me mark the cab so I can glue those on at the end. We'll take the Wedge body off there. This is how the body will sit on the chassis. It goes into these large holes here. We'll press it in tight after we get the grill in place, and those holes you saw, it all presses in. That's what it's going to look like underneath. With that 350, we'll gently pull that off. The cab looks lovely. You can see how I did my markings on the cab. All the trim was done and whatnot, and then I highlighted the emblems because there are no decals for the emblems on this kit that I could see. It's all racing stuff. So when you want to do those emblems, just use your silver Sharpie or whatever you prefer to use, your bare metal foil, whatever, and go ahead, decorate it up for yourselves. Make it look real cute. Paint the underhood black if you want it to match the way it should, like perfectly factory or whatever. And that 350 sitting underneath there and in the chassis. Just have to line up the exhaust. I just have to push it over, super glue it in, and that'll be all set to go. Otherwise, that 350 is underneath the hood. And our wheels are on. We're just going to friction fit, press our wheels into each wheel back as we go. That is it. Really easy to push together. I'm going to snap that interior in the cab, get everything super glued together, just like using that dollar store super glue, get my cab markers on, get my mirrors on, the little tiny details, get the taillights on. Then I will grab the decal sheet. I've already decided what colors I want to use and what logos I want to use. And when I come back, we'll have the final. It's so cool. Check it out. You see the car I have sitting on the back? Even that big long wagon fits on the back of the racer's Wedge. Every single time I say racer's Wedge, I can't help but think of the AC/DC album Razor's Edge and the song Racer's Wedge. Every single time, if I sing anymore, they'll make me pay royalties. So anyways, real fun kit to put together. Let's get that wagon off the back. You can see the review on that Nova, of course, in another video, but this video is all about the Racer's Wedge 72 Chevrolet pickup cab in the front, Wedge hauler in the back. Of course, you can build a completely stock 72 Chevy long bed as well as this from the parts in the box. I used the beautiful yellow trim decals and the Racer's Wedge emblems and the Chevy parts emblems for the doors. I put on the cab clearance lights and the larger side mirrors. I think I glued the side mirrors on a little too high because they lean in, but whatever. You got to have something to complain about, right? So that'll give people in the comment section that don't listen to a word something to complain about. So that's why I did it. We got those steelies that I did up in steel, like that raw metal color. The side doors will open if you ask them to. The hinges are large enough, and you can put little items in there. Don't forget, it includes all those tools like the hacksaw, the hammer, the vise. We got the jack in here. We got the toolbox in here. It's got a jack also extra in the kit, and it's got all kinds of fun parts and a nice looking interior and a nice representation of the 350. We've got our blocks on the end. We've got our wheel chocks, which you can put in one of three positions depending on the length of your vehicle. And we've got the ramps here, which can be placed in as if you want to simulate a loading and unloading diorama. Excellent kit. I love that morning waterfall paint on there. I scratched up the bed because I don't know any that would have been used more than once or twice that wouldn't have had the paint rubbed off where the tread's going, where everyone's walking back and forth for tools to haul their dragster or their track car or whatever they want, or if it's just used to haul junkers. You know, getting this, you know, the wagon over here that I built, well, it needs repairs. So we'll put it on the back there. We'll get it all situated, and he's got to haul that bad boy in and get it all fixed up. Real easy build. I was surprised at how easily everything lined up. Adding that second axle wasn't a big deal. You want to know the hardest part of the build? Getting the wheelbacks inside the tires. The steelies fit inside the black wall side, but man, pushing those wheelbacks, exercise the thumb and forefinger before you start and press them down on a table, and you'll get them together, but they are pretty tight fits. So it's a cool little display. It'll allow you to display one of your big fancy cars that you're really super proud of. You can stick it on the back there and give it a little more emphasis on the back of that really cool Chevy. A Copo Camaro or something like that would look really sweet sitting on the back, or a clunker that they're hauling to the shop to restore into a nice car. It's just an excellent fun kit to build. The grill detail is awesome with that bow tie. The engine looks nice. Underneath is extremely plain. We got to glue on that extra axle and stuff like that, but it still looks nice. You saw what I did with it, and it looks absolutely fine. Thanks for watching the workshop. Thanks for Round 2 Models for sending this over. I will link in the description where you can get this bad boy on pre-order if it's not out already. Otherwise, there'll be links. Those links will be valid when it is in stock. Thanks for watching the workshop. Build your kits for you. Build the version of the racer's wedge or the stock 72 Chevy the way you want, and don't worry what anyone else thinks. Just have fun with your hobbies like I do. We'll see you all at the next review.